Let me share the screen. I am the topic given for me is concrete and five magnificent elements of nature. They are called Panchabhutas. நான் எப்பவுமே வந்து கஷ்டமான ஒரு டாபிக்கை எடுத்துட்டு கஷ்டப்படுறதுன்னு வழக்கம். அதே வழக்கத்துல தான் இந்த டாபிக் எடுத்தேன். When Tendral has suggested you can choose any topic you like, I thought why don't I take it a different way of communicating the concrete view. So hence this reason, hence this topic. Most of you may be knowing the fundamentals of concrete and the great five elements of nature. So let me go back some 23 centuries earlier. So the concrete was the beginning. The beginning of the concrete was made by the great Romans. The ancient Roman concrete was a mixture of lime mortar, aggregate and pozzolana. Over the centuries, this concrete has been improved and has come to the present state of what we are doing and what we are practicing now. The concrete is a great material. The reason, one reason is anybody can make it at any time without any machinery, or highly sophisticated concrete can be made with 100% control over the workability and the strength. So this is the greatness of the material. It is a rich atmosphere can be made, or extremely low atmosphere can be made. So let's see what are the Panchabhutas. The video has not come very well. Anyway, in Abhirami Andadi, there is a 68th poem, Parum Punalum Kanalum Bengalum Padar Visumbum. That is, Parum Punalum Kanalum Bengalum Padar Visumbum. Par means earth, punal means water, kanal means fire. Kanal means fire. Bengalum means the wind. Padar Visumum means the ever without any border, the space. All these things are put together, we have got the nature. So in this nature, so how our people have seen that nature. For us, the entire life, I think so many people have shared so many thoughts on this Panchabhutas, Panchabhutas and the human life, human body, etc. And I thought, why don't we have it, the Panchabhutas as a connection with concrete. So our ancient people in our society, in southern society, said the Panchabhutas are the life of our people. So thus they thought the gods are the Panchabhutas only. They have devoted certain places for the Buddhas are the magnificent elements of nature. The space, we have got element temple at Chidambaram, Agni Thiruvannamalai, Vayu Kalahasti, Jala Thiruvannaikal Trichy, Bhumi at Kanjipuram. So, but this is this worshipping. But how our people are used in life? Actually, when our people have came down from north, they have crossed the Afghanistan, present Afghanistan, and came to Sindhu. They have seen a fertile land. In that fertile land, they were able to see the water coming from the northeast. They called it as Jala. Sun is rising in the southeast. They called it as Agni. And the southwest monsoon starts from the north west corner. So this is the way they have recognized it, and the Vastu Sastra begins. Later, so many attributes have been given to Vastu, but we will not go about it. But as a present, they have recognized these elements as a part of civil engineering, and then they have proceeded. What is that? The cement, ancient cement we have seen, was excavated from the earth, but later it was only a splint of a Britisher. He said, this earth, when subjected to fire, will become a very hard mass. So this is how this cement has come in. Our cement has come in. So our cement, so let us start the organization. I said organization. I concrete as a material. When I have thought this topic, I found it extremely difficult how to put concrete as a companion of these five elements. So I have got, these are concrete has been made by the five elements. Then concrete has been attacked by all these five elements, nature confronting concrete. Later, present days, concrete is confronting nature, and the result, finally, the whole trouble or jugglery or fight has been resolved as a the conflict of the concrete versus nature has been tried. We are trying to resolve it. What is the way we are trying to resolve it? We'll say the later part of the lecture. So, I think there is nothing exists in the world which is not the part of the nature. So, how the concrete has got from nature? It has, the limestone and clay have been quarried from the earth. Water has been mixed and stored in the silos. This mixture is fed into the rotary kiln. Air and fire are used for burning. Then the burnt gas has left to the space. So all the five elements are there in the process of making the ordinary Portland cement. Let us come to another cement which is being used prevalently in our engineering, that is slag cement. People said slag is, it's konja tamil paduthina kashtama irukku. Slag is the kasadu nu peru, adhaadu edhukku laayik illada oru porul adha slag nu solluvom. But here the things are different. The limestone, it is a byproduct or the slag of the blast furnace. I hope you know that blast furnace, the iron ore and the limestone are fed from the top. Coal dust and natural gas are fed from the bottom. The iron ore with the catalyst of the limestone melts, and the iron, the steel is taken out. The slag settles to the bottom and taken out. What is the slag? Iron ore has got the earth or the mud which contains the silica and clay. Limestone is the material which is used for as a catalyst. So the all the things, so limestone and the mud is the material with which ordinary concrete, ordinary cement has been made. So the hard material is has got the cementitious property. Only this slag is mixed with our ordinary OPC pellets and ground gypsum is added, and that is how you have got your blast furnace slag, plus the slag cement. I think our ICC people and all the people know the slag cement has got a better workability, better durability, and slightly higher strength than ordinary OPC or PPC. So this is how the where actually the limestone and ore are from the ground. Coal dust is also from the ground. Gas is in the form of wind and the fire, and all these things form the components of the nature. Hence, the great five elements are, we can conclude, the five elements are making the cement. So the cement is due to the five elements, and the aggregate is also due to the five elements. So the concrete is the child of all the five elements. The child is grown up now. How it is grown up? First, this child, this concrete, which is mixed and mixed with water, have become, plus heat of hydration, the cement gel binds the aggregate particles to make the concrete. And the when just like a child goes in trouble, so the curing is done with compensating heat of hydration. So the only thing I want to stress here is all these things we know. Most of these want to stress is the water in the concrete has got two types. With the mortar which you mix in the concrete is having two types. One which is used for hydration and another is a free. The free water is needed for keeping the workability. So the chemically combined water makes the hydrated compound, and the over the hydrated compound the surface forces makes the water absorb, or on the surface it is being retained. So many times the people ask the question, sir, I have made my concrete today at 1 o'clock, 1:30 I had a heavy rain, will my concrete lose strength? This is question number one. Question number two, I am making a concrete in a pit where the water table will rise up immediately. Sir, I pump out the water and I am able to make the footing, and immediately the water rises up. What is that I should have done? Sir, only thing I am able to do is I am able to reduce the water cement ratio. How much you can reduce? But immediately the water comes in and occupies the concrete which we have laid yet just a minute earlier. The answer is very clear. The surface forces of the gel are absorbed water along the hydrated compounds will not allow any other water to intrude in their privacy. So the moment you add the water and you lay it on the formwork or the floor or the footing, the just forget about it. The cement and water, they know, they will start the family, and at the water and the cement cannot be separated by ordinary means. A physical means, perhaps, very harsh dumping or movement will separate them. Otherwise, they will remain as such. And don't bother about the rain coming after 5 minutes, after you are laying the concrete. Once you mix it, the things are settled for cement and concrete, cement and water. Then, let's go to the child which grows up, and the father wants to test the child's capacity to confront the world. He tests him several ways. First way is the fire. And many times people ask the question, "Sir, why don't we are not making just a foreign world, the structures made up of steel?" Presently, in Coimbatore also, we are making a steel structures. I have framed type, ground plus one or ground plus two or ground plus three. We can make ground plus five, ground plus six or ground plus 10 or 100, etc. But the only problem is your National Building Code 2016, or the rules given in the code are given for our safety. The steel structures are allowed only for ground floor or alone. Ground plus first. Steel structures have to satisfy a rule. The steel structure can withstand the fire for half an hour, while the concrete cover itself can withstand the fire for 1.5 hours. So this is the greatness of the concrete. This concrete will resist the fire, as seen in the graph, up to 400 degrees, or in many concrete it is 300 degrees. 300 to 400 degrees, the concrete can resist the fire without any damage. And it will not allow for 1.5 hours, it will not allow the fire to reach the steel which is protecting, or a minimum cover of about 25 mm of beam and 40 mm per column will able to withstand the fire for 1.5 hours, and that too with an extreme temperature. So this is the reason why the concrete buildings are prevalent in India, while steel buildings still yet to come. We have made a comparison. In Trivandrum, a 16-story building has been designed by a consultant in Mumbai as a concrete. And the client wanted to know how much difference it will be when they make it with steel. We made a thorough calculation. The steel building around 25% cheaper. And when we projected this in a meeting, finally we said one word: this steel building has to be protected by a cover. This cover can be of asbestos. Cover, presently the cover is done by a specific cement called Indo cement paint. The paint is extremely costly. In finally, even though the material is cheaper, for covering it or protecting it against fire, we need to spend lot. So the whole project has been, we ourselves recommended go for concrete. So this is the reason why the steel buildings are yet to come. Maybe the Indo cement paint or any fire protection material, when it comes cheaper, we may go for it. we may go for strict structures. So then why do you say the same thing is applicable to other countries also? There are two basic reasons. Most of the European countries and US, their life is only for 6 months. They have to do everything in 6 months. Another 6 months, there is no life. Number one. Number two, the labor is extremely costly. So most of the products are factory made. The factory making steel is more amenable than concrete. Hence, in foreign countries, the steel is the material. For countries like India, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, the most alternative or the material for construction will be the concrete for time to come. So the fire on the steel, I said immediately after 600 degrees it comes to zero. After 600 degrees the fire on steel will make it totally useless. 10% will be there. The 600 degrees, you see, concrete retains 70% of its strength. And can we say anything on the I hope many of our friends might have visited certain buildings where the fire has been ravaged for 4 hours or 5 hours. The people or the owner or the clients want to know whether the building is safe. A test can be done. Rebound hammer test can be done, or a core test can be done. Immediately they would like to have an answer. So colors of the concrete after the fire will give you certain clue. The gray, the concrete color will remain gray only up to 300 degrees centigrade. The covers might have been small, or the cracks might have been there, but don't be bothered. There can be repellency with a simple finish. Then, the next color we can see is a pink or red. So the temperature has gone beyond 300 degrees. The calcium hydrate has been calcined and it has become a different material. You can see pink or red. Then you will be seeing beyond 600 degrees whitish gray, or beyond 900 degrees rough. Up to pink 600 degrees, the building can be used as such with cosmetic repair. Beyond 600 degrees, when you see the white color or a buff color, you think about something has gone wrong. The whole building has been subjected to a very, very severe fire. So further tests are required and further rehabilitation measures are extraordinary high standard are to be done. Come to the conclusion only when you see the white or buff color. Then another, this is a very, very common attack. The concrete is, the nature makes the concrete, the corrosion. Corrosion, when the steel rod is protected firmly, if there is an alkaline material around the steel rod will remain as such. I hope many of our practicing engineers, as soon as they get the steel rod, they give a slurry coating on the steel rod. They remain in the atmosphere for 6 months without corrosion. The same thing is true when it is put there. A chemical action. Here, the two of the elements which have made the concrete are attacking the concrete. They are, one the air, another is the moisture. They go into the micropores and then destroy the concrete and then further destroy the steel. So this is well known for you, so we will not dwell on it. So the only thing is, there is something called carbonation. So perhaps a little understood a word. Over the years, the carbon dioxide will penetrate into the concrete and the calcium hydroxide will be made into a calcium carbonate, the face powder, without any strength or just a powder. So this is the reason over the years, how much is the life of a concrete structure? The life of a concrete structure, we don't have any other social requirements. The concrete structure remain ever, maybe 100 years. Actually, when the concrete structure well protected, easily you can say 200 years. Without any blemish, the concrete structure will stand. But it's not true in an atmosphere where heavy carbon dioxide or heavy pollution is there. The heavy pollution makes the carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide penetrates into the pores and the concrete gradually becomes a powder, lose the strength. So the buildings which are over 50 years unprotected in a polluted area, they lose the strength just like that, and many times they come down as a pack of cards. Air voids, we know that the air voids are there in concrete, but when the air voids are more, every 5% more ever ride, 5% strength will be reduced for just 1% increase of the voids. So we will not more deal with this air voids, because the air voids increase the workability of the concrete. Minimum air void is necessary. So the air voids will be there. Once the water cement ratio is increases, or when the compaction is not up to the standard, or there is a loose of the slurry because of the segregation. So all these things may provide the higher air voids and higher probability of lesser in strength. Now let's go to the topic. Now, how the concrete which has got now grown up and it attacks their makers. The one is concrete production. See the amount of the concrete which has been produced and see the amount of the cement that is being used from 2000 to 2020. Fivefold. It was in 2000, it was 200 kg per capita. Presently, three times is there within 20 years. So, what will make so this is a cement plant. The cement plant necessarily uses pollutants. One is the fuel, another the burning gases. So 8 to 10% of the world's CO2 emissions come from the manufacturing of the cement. The global warming is mainly due to the carbon dioxide, which is responsible for making the holes in the ozone layer. So there is an immediate necessity of reducing this carbon dioxide. The cement making provides at least at almost around 30% of the carbon dioxide present in the world. Now, we know the story about sand. We are very clear about why the sand mining has been depleted and has been put to almost a full stop in Cauvery Bay. So when you travel from Coimbatore to Trichy, you might have seen about some 50 or 60 years back when you travel, you will be seeing every side coconut grows. Now nothing is there. So the sand mining reduced the permeability of the land. So still people are insisting on the river sand. So in India, then second is we are importing sand. See, you will see 2010 or so, the Indian sand requirement about 572 million dollars imported. So how much we have spoiled our nature, that is another story. So our concrete makes the land, water, everything to a question of life and death. Third, aggregate mining, that's what we have said. Then the third point, first point is carbon dioxide. The second point is our depletion of sand. Third point is the aggregate mining. Fourth, the demolition waste. The demolition waste, concrete demolition happens due to destruction of the old structure, or due to the earthquake, or flood, or wars. Then when we want to remove a building for constructing a permanent or a road or in the laboratory, concrete cubes and cylinders are examined. So, and you can see every corner of an SM lab, you will be seeing only a piling of cubes, etc. Piling of the cubes which have been tested. So these are three reasons. So where the nature has been put to a test by the concrete. We have to resolve the conflict. Concrete has to be made. The country's growth or the society's growth depending upon the concrete. Second, the more the concrete, more will be its sustainability for a good environment. The environment will be lost. So there is a conflict between life or sustaining the environment. How we are going to resolve the conflict? I'll just give you a fair idea. It is for you to develop further. The concrete which we are making has to be made in a different way if we want to save the nature. What are the ways? Reduce, reuse, recycle. So these words are coined with the word, the concrete called green concrete. Green concrete is a concrete where the materials are optimized. The recycling of the and waste management of the aggregate as well as the water, and innovation in materials and the process, and improvements of your concrete making practices. So when all these things are made, still we can survive with increased use of concrete. So the green concrete is trying to use the waste material as one of its components. The production process has to be simple and should not lead to environmental destruction. It should have the high strength, high durability, high performance, and lifetime cycle sustainability. And all these things are necessity of the good concrete. The good concrete will be made in this way. It's called a green concrete. So, what are the greener technologies which we have to examine? Everybody, including the cement manufacturers, the concrete manufacturers, and the concrete user, have to see an alternative to the present technologies. The cement companies, cement plants, have been given a restriction on the reduction of carbon dioxide emissions. They are doing it in two different ways. One, the energy required for making the clinker and the heat required has been modified. Instead of the coal, they are trying to use oil. They are trying to use bio oils. So all these things, certain things are in research, certain things have been developed and being used. So I said fuel derived from the fossil in the cement manufacturing process. Then the savings, the use of cement through the substitution of the fly ash waste in the higher portion, or the use of the other wastes. I think Hugon Cray has been now raised. I don't know who have said that. When we increase the fly ash, the concrete strength will go down, or durability of the concrete element will be lost, or the reinforcement will be corroded earlier. These are the concepts present people are having. Presently, a higher fly ash is being used than it was about few years back. I don't think there is anything wrong. The cement is as good as the earlier cement. Now, I am going to tell later, there are places where more fly ash being mixed with the ordinary clinker. Then I will tell you later. But the new cement new cements are coming: inorganic, formic, alkali aggravated cement, magnesia cement, sulfo aluminate. They are there in a different way, but they will be used in a higher volume later. Then various possibility of the cement, concrete and water, the recycled aggregate can be used. I will come to later. Alternative aggregates, I think we have made a beginning where the thermo hardening polymers are being used as an aggregates. Technologies to come. I think we want to copy our physical world. The physical world, the more strength with less cement is possible when the aggregates are properly packed. The aggregates are properly packed the high density packing, the best example is our human bone. So the human bone density achievement is through the nanoparticles. So people are experiment on the nano cement and alkali activated cement. I'll come to that later. Magnesia cements and sulfur aluminate cements are a possibility. Utilization of geopolymers, a big word, is it right? I will come to that later. So I said natural pozzolanic concrete, 50% of the cementitious compound, 50% of the cement can be replaced with the fly ash. The only rule is try to see the fly ash is not containing any sulfur. That there are cases 70%, and in USA where the earthquake zone area, California, they have used 100% fly ash with glass particles are making the structures which can withstand earthquake. Then I think our Madurai gentleman professor has made thermo hardening polymers as an aggregate and made the roads. The reuse of concrete debris as an aggregate has to be examined with certain question marks. Concrete debris agreement will consume more water, extremely poor strength, and need more energy for compact. All these things are negative things. Positive things are the debris can be used as an aggregate in certain purpose where the strength is not much or where packing is going to be needed, etc., etc. So the recycling of the aggregate, I said we have to see it in a different way. The demolition is there and it can be used as a concrete rubble. The road surface, we can use it. Or you go further, high quality aggregate manufacturing plants are there where the cycles, the aggregate is recycled and used as a ready mix concrete, come back to the concrete structure. Or it can be, so cement can be separated as a clinker and then be used. The whole story goes by this recycling of the aggregate is possible and it is a worth component of research in the days to come. Then there is a word called geopolymer concrete. Concrete is made by reacting aluminate and silicate bearing materials with a caustic solution activator. சாதாரண வார்த்தையை ரொம்ப கஷ்டமா சொல்றது. Fly ash and the ground granulated blast furnace slag. Usually they call it GGBS. Fly ash or blast furnace slag எடுத்துக்க வேண்டியது. அதுக்குள்ள வந்து சோடியம் பொட்டாசியம் பேசி சோடியம் ஹைட்ராக்சைடு ஆர் சோடியம் சிலிகேட் சொல்யூஷனை வச்சு இது இது ரெண்டும் சேர்ந்ததுன்னா சிமெண்டா ஆக்ட் பண்ணும். ஃப்ளையாஸ் ஆர் ஸ்லாக் எடுத்துட்டு தட் மேட் வித் பொட்டாசியம் ஹைட்ராக்சைட் சொல்யூஷன் ஆர் சோடியம் சிலிகேட் சொல்யூஷன். சோடியம் சிலிகேட் சொல்யூஷன் பைண்டிங்காக பவுண்ட்ரியில் நம்ம இதுவே யூஸ் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்காங்க. ஸோ இது ஒன்றும் புதுசு கிடையாது. ஸோ அந்த ஃப்ளை ஆஷ் உள்ள சோடியம் சிலிகேட் சொல்யூஷன் யூஸ்னா அதுக்கு பேர் ஜியோபாலிமர் கான்கிரீட். அது நேச்சுரல், இதில் சிமெண்ட் கிடையாது, சிமெண்டே இல்லை. நேச்சுரல் சாண்ட் அண்ட் கோர்ஸ் அக்ரிகேட்ஸ் ஆர் ஜாயின். ஐஐடி சென்னை இஸ் டூயிங் அ லாட் ஆஃப் ரிசர்ச் ஆன் தட். தே கம் பேக் வித் வெரி வெரி novel methods of making geopolymers, and many structures have been made. They are willing to help you when you want to construct a structure with a geopolymer. There is an end. The geopolymer is the modern equivalent of the ancient concrete that has been used by Romans, that survived thousands of years. முதல் ஸ்லைடும் இதே தான், ரோமன் கான்கிரீட் தான். கடைசியில் எல்லா ஃபேஷனும் ஒரே மாதிரி முடிகிற மாதிரி. கான்கிரீட் இஸ் ஹேவிங் எ நியூ பிகினிங், நியூ பிகினிங் வேர் த ஓல்டு நியூ பிகினிங் இஸ் ஃப்ரம் அகெயின் 2300 இயர்ஸ் ஓல் கான்கிரீட். ஸோ லெட்ஸ் மேக் த நியூ பிகினிங். அண்ட் ஐ டோன்ட் கால் திஸ் இஸ் த எண்ட் ஆஃப் த லெக்சர், this is the beginning of the lecture. Thank you very much for your patient listening.